The Flip Side with Michael Loftus is brought to you by
Cronies. They're connected.
Get ready for the all-new Cronies action figures.
Yeah!
Help the Cronies battle against their small business rivals, the entrepreneurs.
They'll steal your customers, your superior products, and crush your profit margins with competition.
Here comes Parts and Labor, the team mechanic and his scrappy junkyard dog. This handyman knows how to grease the wheels of power.
We're under competitive attack from a foreign invasion.
Raise the trade barrier.
Terrified. Behold Bancor, the mystical prophet. Part prophet, part profiteer. This Wall Streeter stacks the deck, rigs the game, and makes the rain.
Oh no, I'm underwater. I need a bailout.
Activating G-Force.
Take to the skies with Aerial Striker. Her awesome armaments are a no-bid license to overkill.
She's powerful. She's wasteful.
Boondoggle.
Every team needs a leader. That's Big G. He's got the monopoly on G-Force, the ultimate source of crony power.
I am
Big G.
Enter Big G's command chamber through the revolving doors on K Street and get connected to the G-Force.
The G-Force.
Find out more at thecronies.com.
All right, welcome back to The Flip Side. Hey, next up, we're going to be joined by Mr. John Popola. He was a producer and director at Spike TV, Nickelodeon, and MTV. Now, he is the president and creative director of Emergent Order, the guys behind The Cronies. Please welcome to the stage, John Popola. Come on out here to The Flip Side. Good to have you,
man. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, good times. So we saw The Cronies. You actually made the characters. It was nuts. What are you looking to do with The Cronies?
Well, we teamed up with Generation Opportunity, which is a like-minded free market organization. And the whole idea was, how do we crack this nut of explaining to people that, you know, this corrupt intersection of big government and big corporations isn't capitalism?
Yeah.
It's crony capitalism. It's corrupt. And since I was a producer at Nickelodeon, this was a natural fit for me and my partners, so it was like, oh, well, of course we'll do action figures.
Oh, yeah, you have to do action figures. Who's the girl with the wings?
Oh, Aerial Striker.
Aerial Striker, that's fantastic. I kind of want that action figure myself. I'd like that. So how do you go from MTV, Spike TV, to doing this, to getting fired up about crony capitalism?
I just got fired up about Ron Paul, and I wanted to learn more about what was he all about, why did he seem to see this whole financial crisis coming, and that sent me down an economics rabbit hole from which I have never returned.
Yeah, something happens, all of a sudden tumblers click, and your life just goes a different way.
Well, I think the problem is that you have this, this sort of progressive narrative, which I think is well-intentioned but wrong, which is that government exists to stand up against big corporate interests or big and powerful interests, and the fact of the matter is, throughout history, big government's ability to pick winners and losers has always been captured by special interests. It's always been a tool of the powerful to rig the rules in their favor. And I think the challenge we always face with, if you believe in liberty, is how do you have a government that creates rules that apply to everybody equally? You know, we're actually the side that believes in equality, equality under the law.
Yeah.
So you don't get a subsidy and I don't pay for it. We all basically get to have a shot at doing something great, and if it doesn't work out, we don't get to pass our bad ideas on the rest of us.
Thank goodness for your videos. The rap video that explains the economic, I think we have a clip of that.
We could have done better had we only spent more. Too bad that only happens when there's a world war. You can carp all you want about stats and regression. Do you deny World War II cut short the Depression?
Wow, one data point and you're jumping for joy. The last time I checked, wars only destroy.
What were you looking to get out of the rap battle of the economists, I guess it would be?
Well, like I said, so Ron Paul was talking about this financial crisis, and who was giving him the sort of inspiration for understanding this thing? It was economists like Friedrich Hayek, people that they called them the Austrian economists because they're from Austria. And they have a fundamentally different way of looking at the way the world works than the mainstream, which is the sort of Keynesian economist, John Maynard Keynes' inspiration. So Paul Krugman, Keynesian. Ron Paul, Hayekian.
Yeah.
And when everything came crashing down, it was we got into all this trouble because we spent too much money and had too much debt, so what we need to do is spend more money and get into more debt.
Yeah, keep spending money. Just keep, like, break the window, so we need to buy a window.
Paul Krugman is a Keynesian, very proudly so, and right after 9/11, he wrote a piece about how 9/11 would be good for the economy. Because, of course, you have to rebuild the buildings.
Oh, wow.
And so a Hayekian would say, well, it would actually be pretty awesome if we built buildings and actually had the old ones too.
Yeah.
It ultimately boils down to a fundamental view of where knowledge and good incentives come from. And the Keynesian view fundamentally believes, and he was very much an elitist as a person, that it's the top down. It's the technocratic elites. They are our betters, and they should be able to plan the society, and they should be able to allocate our hard-earned resources the way they see fit because we're basically too dumb.
Yeah.
The Hayekian view says no, they don't have the knowledge to do that well. Even if they're angels, they don't know what each of us need because each of us need different things. And we all exist in diverse communities that have very specific needs. And there's no way you can basically plan that all out from a central location in Washington, D.C., or in the case of the Soviet Union. I mean that was one big failed experiment in top-down control of the economies.
What's next? What are you guys working on now?
Well, we've got a great little web show called Econ Pop, where we review movies from an economics point of view.
So What have you done so far?
Oh, so we're just releasing the new episode is about the economics of Elysium.
This is Matt Damon.
Right, so
he's on Earth and it's all jacked up and he wants to
He's on Earth and it's all terrible and it basically looks like Bangladesh and only it's, 100 years in the future. But somehow in this space station, you've got robots that can cure cancer with the push of a button. And yet he works in a robot factory where he has to microwave the robots. And it's like, I would think if you could have robot doctors, you could probably have robots to microwave the robots. In fact, you could probably have, everybody would have robots. Everywhere would look amazing if we had robots like that.
Yeah.
And so right from the start, you have this sort of strange zero-sum game. If there's people that have a lot, it must be because they took it from somebody.
Right.
But for the most part, in a system that you have rules of the game, where you have private property, the only way you can make anything for yourself is to create value for somebody else. I can't force you to buy something from me.
Yeah.
I can't force you to buy my video. I have to make it good enough that it creates value for you.
That's awesome.
That's capitalism. It's like you don't get to receive unless you give.
Amen to that. Hey, where can we find out more?
So you can check us out at emergentorder.com. But if you want to learn more about economics, the best place to go is econstories.tv, which is the home to the raps and a lot of other content like
there Econ. There you go. Pop. You got to see them. You got to check it out. And thank you so much for being on the show. You made me a little bit smarter. Hey, thanks a lot.
Thanks again, man.
Stick around. More Flipside.